the New Jerusalem.
Silver cities. It collapsed back to three dimensions of space and one dimension of time. And that was the fall. And it took another being that had to somehow re-fertilize mankind with this multidimensionality to intervene in our lives and get us back to this point. Because after all, heaven is going to be a multidimensional place. And the tree of life in Revelation, the tree of life exists in paradise as well as it existed in the garden. Same tree of life. Because this is multidimensional, that was multidimensional. There was a collapse of some kind to three dimensions of space, one of time. That began the animal nature, evolution, everything that had to happen until God intervened, impregnated the ovum of a woman, bore a son who had no sin nature, no animal nature, and reinvigorated the human race. And I think that's what all the stories of the Savior in all the cultures were telling us. It was telling us from Cro-Magnon days when this collapse happened. It was saying, don't worry, in the course of time, this is going to happen. The Savior will come, and you will be restored. And this is what we'll have. Glorified bodies. Bible says we'll have glorified bodies. What does that mean? I don't know what it means. It's going to glow. It's going to have power. It's going to have multidimensionality. How this happens, I can't tell you. That's the thing. But I can only say this, is that I believe the whole world is telling you this story. I think it's been telling you this story for 6,000 years now. And I think that the person that we have to think about now is this Savior Jesus? You have to come to that conclusion. If you're a Buddhist, you'll say, no, it's Maitreya. If you're Jewish, you'll say, no, it's Messiah. If you're Hindu, you'll say, no, it's Kalki. If you're Islamic, you'll say, no, it's the 12th Imam, Mahdi al-Muntazir, the expected one. And that's okay. That's okay. But I think all the evidence to me just seems to point from cross to casket and tomb to eclipse. I'm not even going into the Bibles, all the 70 or 80 prophecies that have been fulfilled. The Bible prophecies, I'm just talking about the general world prophecies of all the world, not just the Bible. If I went to the Bible, I mean, take 1 minute. All these prophecies. Offspring of a woman, this prophecy was given in 1490 BC. Promise offspring of Abraham, given in 1490 BC. Promise offspring of Isaac, given in 1490 BC. Promise offspring of Jacob, 1490 BC. Will descend from the tribe of Judah, 1490 BC. The heir to the throne of David, 760 BC. Place of birth being Bethlehem, 450 BC. Time of birth, that was also given. Born of a virgin, 760 B.C. Slaughter of the infants, 629 B.C. Escape from Egypt, 785 B.C. Ministry in Galilee, 760 B.C. Was a prophet, 1457 B.C. A priest like Melchizedek, 1000 B.C. Rejection by the Jews, 760 B.C. Other characteristics, 760 B.C. Triumphal entry, 520 B.C. And I got two more pages of this. These are all fulfillments of Jesus. who fulfilled every single one of these prophecies. Plus a couple more pages. That's the Bible focusing in on the world savior story. All I've been doing is taking the most general Egypt, India, Mexico, Central America, ancient Hawaii, Persia, and just giving you the most general focus, just narrowing it down. And we got to Buddha, and we got to Buddha saying 500 years after his death. Then we get to the book of Daniel, and he says 483 years after the proclamation. And little by little, we come to a focus point. Either there is a savior or there is no savior. If there's no savior, that's okay with me too. But if there's a savior, I want to know. I want to know who it is. And I want to know what to do about it once I discover who it is. Questions? Everyone's stunned. We got 5 minutes. Let me say thank you for the classes. This has been something that's been bouncing around in my head now since 1990, you can imagine. And I've come to the conclusion, and I'm going to say this at the very end, myself, I've come to the conclusion that in everything that I can see in terms of the world savior, that Jesus fulfills everything. This is the church time now. This is the time of grace. This is not the kingdom time. This is a time when the doors are open. So this is a time of grace. This is a time when you can come into the kingdom without having to martyr yourself. You can come in just freely by faith. It's a-